Location shooting is a practice of filmmaking in which the production process is taken into real-world situations and scenarios instead of being shot in indoor sets or studio backlots. It could offer a greater sense of realism in the narrative. I mean, thinking about location shooting, it's very instructive to look at classical Hollywood. One way in which location shooting was incorporated is to have a camera crew, often the second unit camera crew, go to those sites to capture the footage and use that footage as intermediary shots spliced in between action shots that are produced in the studio. A good example of this could be seen in the film Tokyo Joe, which is a film in which Humphrey Bogart visits Tokyo right after the Second World War. There's an early scene in which Bogart walks through the black market of Tokyo. And if you look at the scene, because Humphrey Bogart never went to Japan, you see a scene of a bogey double wearing a trench coat and a hat walking on the actual streets of a Tokyo black market. That's captured from behind, never showing the face of the actor. And that cuts to a medium shot of Bogey walking in an artificially constructed black market in the studio. And there's a sense of awkwardness in the scene because there's something visually incoherent. The scene is undermined by the fact that the choice was made to primarily shoot this film in the US. So the invisible is made sort of visible because of the fact that the shooting takes place in multiple places. Now, the outcome could be different if you actually shoot the entire scene on location. And one example of this could be seen in Tokyo File 212, which is an independent production, a co-production with a Japanese company. And this is a film in which Robert Peyton, the protagonist, goes to Japan to expose a communist spy ring. Peyton sort of glides through the city to go from point A to point B. But because this scene is shot on location entirely, there is a visual consistency that's pretty evident. It's a scene that's comparable to the rickshaw scene in Tokyo Joe, but because once again in Tokyo File 212, the scene is shot in Japan, it seems like there's a unity and consistency in what appears on screen. I'm not saying that Tokyo File 212 is a more successful film than Tokyo Joe, but there seems to be a visual unity and some advantages to actually shooting film on location because it does feel a little more authentic from a spatial and place perspective.